welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to share with you guys my haul from the new Target designer collection with Love Shack Fancy. So if you don't know what or who Love Shack Fancy is, it is a designer out of New York, and she designs a lot of feminine boho pieces, really pretty frills and eyelet material, a lot of embroidery and florals, very girly and boho. So if you're into that kind of style, then this is your dream collection. I think everything was under $60, and normally things retail for a lot. Let's just say it's a lot of money. So quick story, I totally forgot about the launch, being a mom and being exhausted. I forgot to set my timer, but anyways, I woke up in the morning, realized it was June 6th when the collection launched, and I went online and everything was already sold out in my size. So I basically got ready, jumped in my car, and went to Target. And luckily they still had everything still there in stock in my size. So I grabbed everything you see here, but a little tip, I know I went to Target, I'm filming this the next day, and I went to Target today, this morning. One of the associates was actually bringing back things that people exchange, and the store associate there that I spoke to yesterday was urging everyone to buy two sizes if you don't know your size or if you're kind of unsure what size to buy, just because it wasn't letting anyone try on anything because of the pandemic. So a lot of people bought like the dresses the same style in two sizes, so a lot of people will be returning things. So my suggestion would be to go a little early to Target and see if you can look out and get some things. Also, I also called another Target, and they said that they weren't gonna launch the collection in stores until June 15th. So if that's the case, I would check with your local Target in hopes to get something from this collection, because it is so beautiful. Like, oh my god, the things, like the dresses, are so dreamy and so whimsical, and I love it. They also had two other designers a part of the whole launch, but a lot of the styling wasn't really my style, so I just gravitated towards the Love Shack Fancy dresses. So I'll show you guys what I picked up, and then I'll do a little clip in so you guys can see the full thing. Also, before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'm trying to get to 1,000 subscribers, so I'd really appreciate your support. Also, follow me on Instagram. I post a lot of fashion content on there. I also do a lot of sales and deals on my stories, so if you guys want to check that out, I'll have the link below. Also, like this video, and also leave me a comment below letting me know if you got anything from this collection. So, without further ado, let's just get started. So the first thing I want to share with you guys is this dress. Oh my god. So once I saw the advertisement for the whole collab and everything, and I saw this dress, I knew I had to have it. This was the dress I was hunting down yesterday morning, trying to see if they had it in stock. It's kind of funny too, because my Target said that it was sold out, and I just went there anyways just to see, and they had a couple sizes in my size, in the size up and the size down. So I mean, I don't know why I said it was already sold out, but anyways, I was so happy I got it. So this is white eyelet dress. It does have like little mini ruffles on the sides. You can wear the sleeves like this, or you can also wear it off the shoulder, which I think is really pretty as well. It does have a tie here. I tied it in the front, you can tie it in the back, and it is about like a midi length, almost maxi length. For reference, everything I got here is a size small, so I sized up one of them to a medium, and the only reason why is because it's super short. For reference, I'm 5'6", so the dress is super short on me, especially in the front, so I had to go up to a medium, but the bust area was still a little bit loose, but I thought it would have been okay for that style of dress, but you'll see what I'm talking about in a minute. Yeah, but everything I bought in a size small. For reference, I am losing weight since I gave birth, and since I'm starting to transition out of breastfeeding, I'm finding myself going back to my normal size, and that would be a size 4, a small, or a 26 in jeans. Right now I am in between sizes, but I would suggest going a size down if you are unsure. just because I got everything I got in a medium or a six was way too big on me. So I had to go down to a small. Even one of them I thought that I could possibly fit into extra small. But anyways, for reference, everything here is a size small except that one dress is a medium. This dress screams summer to me. I can picture myself wearing some sneakers, my hair in a messy bun with maybe like a scarf wrapped around it. I think this would be like so pretty. So this is kind of short on me, so I would suggest maybe sizing up if you do grab this dress, and even if you can't find your size and you do find the size larger, then I think it would be okay. But this is so cute. And then this one was only, this was on the less expensive side. It was $40 compared to the rest. This one that I am wearing that I just talked about, this one was $60. So the next dress I want to share with you guys is this one. This is so, so pretty. This is one of the dresses that I went this morning and the lady was wheeling it out to put it back on the shelf, and I'm so happy I snagged it. This one retails for $50, and again, it's such a pretty summer dress. This would look perfectly with sneakers, and a lot of the Love Shack Fancy campaigns, they dress their frilly, pretty bohemian dresses with sneakers, and I love that look. I think this would be perfect with that, and it is in a nice thin cotton material, so it's very breathable if you live in a hotter climate. I think this dress would be so, so perfect for that. So here's the same exact dress. This is in a all white colorway. Again, this retails for $50 and it is so gorgeous. This would be perfect for, again, in the summertime. I would wear these with maybe some brown sandals, and again, you'll see how pretty and flattering these are in the clip-ins. I think that the ruffles on the sleeve is very flattering as well, and I'm just so obsessed with this whole collection. Like, everything is so gorgeous. So the next style is this one. I'm so into the whole patchwork trend. I have something from Forever 21 I bought, and it is a like baby doll patchwork dress, and I'm obsessed with this. So when I saw this one, I knew I had to get it. I love how pretty and how flared out it is. This would be perfect if you are pregnant. I think this dress would be perfect. It would glide over your baby bump so nicely, and again, it is so pretty. This one, it retailed for $50. So this dress, I almost passed up. Almost. I was looking for some other pieces that I initially wanted, and then I saw someone grab this off the rack, and I just like stopped out of my tracks and was like, oh my god, that dress is so gorgeous. And then I picked it up and felt the material. It is so soft and silky. I love the contrast bow. I think it kind of like adds a whole whimsical touch to the dress. To me, this just looks like a perfect like Southern Belle kind of dress too, even though I wouldn't know. I'm from the East Coast and I live in the West Coast right now. But I think this would be the perfect dress for that. So I don't know if things are gonna get better soon for us to have large gatherings again, but this would be a nice dress for a wedding, especially a summer wedding. I would even grab this up to just hold in my closet so I have something to wear when things get better, if you are invited to any kind of special events. So this dress, again, I almost passed up on just because I didn't like how it looked online. I just thought it was too much fabric, but I'm glad I picked it up because when I came home and tried it on, I fell in love with it. It is so pretty. I love the sleeves. I love how poofy it is. It just gives more like personality to the dress, I guess. I love the fact that the fabric is so thin. It is a cotton material again, and this one retailed for $60. So I forgot to mention that this one retailed for $55. So this is another dress that again I almost passed up on, but it looks so, so pretty on. Like, I'm so happy I got this one too. This one retails for $60. So this is one of the ones that are a little bit more higher price, but again, for $60 for a dress like this, like, I don't think you would be able to find that anywhere, especially not from this brand itself. Like, you would never be able to find this dress for $60. And the last dress is this one. Again, this is so pretty. This is one of the finds that I did pick up this morning. This one retails for $55. Same concept with the ruching on the top. It does have a bit of a puff sleeve, so if you didn't like the other dresses, like this blue one with this crazy puff sleeve, then this one might be better for you because it's still a puff but not as exaggerated as that one. And again, it does have some ruffle layers and then it has some lace in between the layers, and again, this dress is so pretty. This one is more on the casual side. This would be one of the more casual dresses. If you do want to get something and you think the other ones are, like this one is a little bit too dressy, then something like this would be a good pick. That's all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick little haul. I'm gonna try to edit and upload this video ASAP so I can have it up for you as soon as possible. I know things are now going in and out of stock in the stores. Everything is totally sold out online. I don't know if they're gonna get more inventory online, but I know in stores things are going in and out of stock. People are returning things. For instance, I just returned all of my size 6 and medium dresses, so whoever goes to the store maybe later today or tomorrow, you guys can get those sizes. And I know a lot of people are returning things, so hopefully you can go get your size in your local Target store. Also, Target did ensure that they are taking measures to sanitize any store returns so they're able to put it back on the shelf, so not to worry about that. And yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.